in one line, can you define what are the, what is the core thing? What is the core responsibility of the product owner?
Maintaining the backlog.
Which backlog?
Product backlog.
Anything else?
ROI.
Vision of product. Awesome.
Product owner is one who understands the business.
Right. So I think we all have a fair idea, but I would put it in terms of Scrum. I would say that maintaining the product backlog is its core responsibility. Hands-on, if I'm talking about creating the product backlog. So there, so vision, product vision, envisioning how it needs. So everything is his responsibility and a greater stakeholder on the business side. But when we talk of pure development, his core responsibility is to ensure that product backlog is created well. It is well groomed. It is created in a nice way. Okay. So anything, whatever the product developed, if it is going fine, or if it is achieving the objective, or if it is not achieving the objective, it is whose responsibility? Who owns it?
Product.
We are clear about it. Any question on this? Okay. If we talk of Scrum, so we have seen. So Scrum, let's see what are the different kind of roles that we have in Scrum.
Three roles.
Awesome. What is three roles? Product owner, Scrum Master, and development team. Right. We know that. So the idea of this exercise is that we'll create a team. We'll identify a product owner. We'll identify a Scrum Master, and the team. Team would have what? All team would have?
Developer,
tester, all kind of roles. So we'll find, we'll have developer, we'll have tester. Okay, fine. So, okay, what are the kind of if you say artifacts or document that we have in Scrum?
Three.
You could guess. Good. That's very good. So what is the first one?
Product backlog.
Second one?
Sprint backlog.
Anybody who doesn't know what is sprint backlog? Sprint backlog is product backlog. You have the top items that you want to develop. Okay. So top priorities items you take and plan it in a sprint.
Okay.
Maybe top 3 or 4. And in that sprint, whatever documents, whatever things you take, that comes into a sprint backlog. So sprint backlog, thoda sa aur difference hoga. We'll not go there for now. But for so sprint backlog is whatever is the top 3-4 things that you want to execute or develop in the current sprint. Okay. So sprint backlog, what is the third thing?
Increment.
Document. Is a retrospect document.
No.
No, that's
burn down chart. I'll come to burn down chart. But that is right. You can say that also a document. But what is a, so third thing that we say is, agar aapne dekha, so last thing, when you develop a product at the end, there's something called potentially shippable product increment.
Yes.
Have you heard this?
Yes. Yeah.
What is that?
It is
a component of a product which is working. Yes. So that is the third artifact we say that, you know. But the point is, what you said is a burn down. Burn down, generally we take it as a metric because it is something which we use to, we see the burn down on a day-to-day basis to see how the project, how my sprint is going on. Okay. So we did the roles, artifacts, the activities. What are the three activities? So I said three. What are the three activities? But there is a catch here.
Sprint planning is one. Daily startup is the review and retrospection.
Okay. So review and retrospection are generally when are they done?
At the end.
So we take them as together. So those are three activities. So first is sprint planning. Second is daily stand-ups. Third is review and retrospection. What is the fourth one?
Backlog grooming.
Awesome. So somewhere in between your running of sprint, what you will do is team would sit together and with the product owner, just spend some time in grooming the stories for the next sprint. Because what happens is in the current sprint, when you are doing some development, when you're doing, so you might see that something is coming out. You might have to. So that impacts your product backlog or the upcoming things. So you might want to spend some time dedicatedly in grooming the upcoming sprint. So there are four activities. Sprint planning, daily stand-up, third is review and retrospection, and backlog. So we know the entire story. Right. Now you have already seen that. So what we'll do is, we'll try to do all that. what I'm going to do is we have to make team, and we have to work in team. Now there are 30 people. 6 is a big number, but we'll manage with 6 people, right? 5 teams we'll make. ठीक है, थोड़ा सा आप लोग अपना what we call as self organize, so you can divide and you know we see how the work can be done. But let's that's a good opportunity here. So we can say 1, 2, 3. आप नंबर बोलिए 1, 2, 4, 5, 6. Six, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, three, four, five, six, ठीक है, अब all ones and twos and threes and fours and five and six together. It's a time for you to self-organize. Wait a minute, let me start the clock and let me see how quickly you get into teams together. Twos. Lead management system. Now, you all have a lead management system. You all, in your organization, you apply lead. People have some, you know, organization might different lead policy, but we'll stick to a basic lead management system. Okay. So the person who will drive how the lead management system should come out would be the product. So we need to identify one product owner quickly in our group. Okay. Product owner. Okay. So the job of the product owner is to identify how my lead management system would look like. Okay. One Scrum Master from your teams. Scrum Master. And one tester. Tester. What is the role of a tester in a Agile project? Definition of done. Do you agree? This is the role of tester?
No.
Definition of done is for everybody.
Yes. So everybody defines the role of a tester. Yes, to test.
Before the product is going into the review cycle, he will test whether it's working.
Awesome. The point is, where do you want to, you know, what is the difference of a role of a tester in an agile versus waterfall?
Each iteration has to be passed by.
So that also goes in the waterfall.
So all features are
pretty similar. So to cut it short, there is no difference. The only difference is, see, you do test, you do whatever test, you write test case, you write test plan, everything you will do here. The only difference is involvement of a tester early in the project. Right when you're starting the project, the tester is there. That is the key difference. And then second is bringing in the automation. Right, so that is another thing. Yeah.
You have something to say? Okay.
So that is it. So we have a tester also. Now, what we need to do in our group, okay, before that. Let's try to create a product backlog. So for till the time I say we are all part of you are part of a business team. So you have a product owner and the remaining people are the stakeholders who will define how the product would look like. Right. So what we are trying to do is we are trying to create a product backlog, or we'll say we'll try to create a user story map using which we'll come up with what our LMS would look like. And believe me, your LMS would be different. Okay, so the first step that we want to do is, I'm giving you stickies. You have to write individually without talking to each one of you, without talking, you have to write individually what are all the features you would want to have in your lead management system. Now, one more catch. Lead management system, we are making it for a mobile device. So we all know these Android and iPhone. Right, you know the interface of Android, you use applications in Android, you know how it works. For example, we don't have horizontal scroll bar, we have Generally, mobile applications don't have a horizontal scroll. Yeah, so something of that kind. Just keep that in mind when you are designing this application. So now, for a leave management of a mobile device, what are all features you would want to have in that leave management system? That is what we have to first write individually, okay, without discussing the team. You have to write one feature in one sticky. So I'm giving you these sticky pads. Please use them. Thank you. So, guys, for now, the roles that we have defined, thodi der ke liye wo roles bhul jaiye. Theek hai? Right now, there is a product owner, right? The remaining people are the stakeholders. Or in fact, you can say the end user. So, the product owner is a person from HR, maybe, and the end user are the employees. So, just see from a user perspective, how you would want to have, what you would want to see in an application which is a leave management system on the mobile. Right? Just think from that standpoint. So, first step is, for individual, without discussing, write 4 or 5 or 6 or 10 features that you have in mind, one feature on one stick. Okay, any question?
No.
One feature on one sticky. So you might have five features, you might have 7 features, without discussing, individually. And write it big. Because they might want. So I'm saying, no, one feature in one sticky.
Okay.
One feature and one sticky, you take this. And this is the, one feature per sticky. So, Lindipal, all sticky is not, but sticky share.
You can write as many features.
Yes. As many features as you want to build in your leave management system. You would want to see. थोड़ा बड़ा बड़ा लिखेंगे तो अच्छा लगेगा तो लाइक वन फीचर इज एबिलिटी टू अप्लाई लीव एंड देन यू कैन बी इनोवेटिव यू कैन बी यू नो व्हाट एवर योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डज नॉट प्रोवाइड यू कैन ऐड इट इन योर विश लिस्ट So we are done. Nearly we are done. Whatever we have, good. Good. Now the next step what we're gonna do is apne apni walls pe, whatever wall you have, is start putting the features. So one of the member would whatever he or she has written. First feature, second feature, third feature. Don't think of prioritization or anything. Forget about it. Whatever. Just put. Right? Okay. Then, wait. Then I'll say start, then you do. Okay. Second thing, the second person would come and would put the thing horizontally or vertically. Horizontally means if you think whatever you have is not there in this list, you put it horizontally next. Okay. If you think something is there, which is already written, you put vertically. So this means we will have a list of features which are common and there could be things which are which you might not have thought of. Okay, we have to paste these on these walls. Any question now?
No.
Well, let's do it on our walls. One of you first and one by one.
You're starting
one by one. Please stick them properly.
In total mein up.
Because otherwise they will fall down.
So you have to cut, maybe the corner cut कर दें चलो ठीक है start शुरू करो एक पे चार है ना तुम्हारे
teacher
तो common
तो teacher चार तो नहीं है teacher ही है उसकी detail है
what is this
this is first show the leave log
Okay, and the pasting would be done by the person who has written those
ये clear हो चुकी है अब तक
So you will not give it and pass it on for someone to face it.
Okay? ये नई लीव अप्लाई करने के लिए
हाँ अगर डिफरेंट है तो हॉरिजॉन्टल है सेम है तो
चेक किया फिर अप्लाई किया
नहीं नहीं अलग अलग कॉमन नीचे लगा दो जो कॉमन होगा नीचे लगा दो
आप अपनी सारी हॉरिजॉन्टल लगा दो
This is once it is applied, then automated email to employee and its manager.
He will notify.
Yes. Then approval for manager. When manager approves, then HR check the eligibility and they approve or decline it. And it is reports for manager, for employee, and for HR.
We don't have to get too much discussion. No, if you find it somewhat similar, put them together.
I'll help you.
So observation from individual teams. First thing, when you we see couple of them which are individual kya batate hain? What does individual sticky tell us?
They are different, right?
So they are different means you did not think about it. So whenever you're conceptualizing a product, the best way, so what Agile says is that the concept of product backlog, that you go to the actual users and try to find out what are the requirements. So we are in realistic scenario, what is done is if you are making an application for internal employees or so there's a huge requirement elicitation workshop that is done. It might go from 1 to 2 days to 3 days also, where you will see the huge story walls coming up. People doing the same kind of exercise for that application. Imagine yourself, this team, we see so many intense discussion. You know, this is the first step. We're getting into a discussion of ki yes mein aayega, yes mein aayega. So if you're thinking of a product at a larger scale, you can imagine the amount of discussion it will ask for. Okay, so first step is we have written these requirements, our individual requirements, and when you have collated them, you figured out that there are requirements which you missed. For example, this teammate, anybody who can share something when he saw it written there, right? You found that this is what I thought of.
Yeah.
So notification emails, anything from this team?
Leave and cashment, company holiday calendar, generally log soch lete, but what I'm saying
in your team, what was that thing that was not that, you know, you did not think of and somebody else thought of?
History
was not it. So
auto escalation, auto approval.
auto approval is very important. अगर 3 दिन तक respond नहीं होगा तो approval.
Auto level escalate होगा, फिर अपने आप
approval
हो जाएगा. And my tasks are automatically allocated to my team.
So the point is now depending on so what is happening is depending on the kind of role our requirements are also changing. Right. So, what are these people called? So, in Agile terminology, we have very limited time. I'm just touching on these things. What are we trying to do here? We're trying to write the requirements. These requirements are supposedly written in Agile. We say, what are those called?
Story.
User story. So, when you say user story, who is the user? There could be different kind of user for the same thing. So, like Sarah is saying, as a manager, as a so you have to have auto approval thing. So, if you're thinking from that mindset,
some new requirement would come up. Right. So that's why we call them user story, and we write the same requirement from different user perspective. One word I would want to coin here is there's something called personas.
Persona.
So personas are nothing but what you can say, a simulation of a user. That if that is a user, how he would look like, what would be his behavior when we are thinking of this kind of requirement. So first step is this. Now the next step. Next step is we have listed down these requirements. Now we have to prioritize this. What are the top requirements which are must for me? Okay. So in your thing, so some people have 10, 12, some people have 7, 8, 10. So people, those who have less than 10, you can prioritize top 8 requirements that you want to be there must in your lead management system for the mobile device. Right? For the people, those who have multiple, you can just, okay, anytime you can revisit your board, you can see it, and if you still find, when you're seeing, if you still find there's something which is common, you can feel free and, you know, that thing nobody stops you to. So you can just quickly check your board. If you find that things are common, you can rearrange them. And if these are already rearranged, now you think from a personal perspective of the top priorities you would want to have in your lead management system. Till now, you are not wearing your developer's hat. You are still the end user. Okay. The good part is lead management system. We all apply for leave, so we are actually end user. So now only think from that perspective and mark, probably the top 10 requirements that you would want to have.
Who will do this? All stakeholders.
So who will do this?
Product owner.
No, so product owner, you have come in a meeting, you are developing a product, right? And you are developing a product where everybody has written this requirement. You have also written this, but you only wrote 2-3.
Yes.
They are remaining also, right? So these needs to be prioritized. So entire team would do that. If a team is big, so there could be a representation from teams who understand what are we needing. So as a group, we'll do the simple priority. When I say prioritization, please do not think from a development sequence ki pehle yoga fir yoga. No, we are using the
feature.
Please do not think of feature ki ye pehle approve karenge, fir ye karenge, fir ye karenge. Don't have the flow also in mind. Just think from a feature perspective, what are the most important feature you would want to have. Okay.
Yes,
so right now, you do not do anything. Just tick mark or mark 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Top 10 requirements that you want to have. Can you do it quickly?
Sure.
You have 2 minutes.
Anyone
can do it. Means if you are in sync, you can do.
Yeah, we are
excited.
We already put it like that.
Top 10. Top 10. Top 10
is. We can take it out.
6, 7, 9 are our requirements. What number? अभी बता रहे हैं प्रायोरिटाइजिंग में तो नंबर नहीं है कौन सा पैरेंट अवेलेबल और भी कम हो गया ना.
So why we are bringing them down, you mean to say that these are the common things,
yes.
Meaning the same. Okay, good. Right, can you sit now, wherever we are. That's it. Okay. Right.
Time box.
We all are coming from different companies. We all know that we have come on Saturday, but still, when we are going to draft it, make the product backlog, we are so passionate about it, right? Because we use it, right? And so that is the kind of thing that goes into the product. You can bet if I do the same exercise with the entire group, the LMS would have all the features that you can think of. So that is the power of getting the user story mapping done. Okay, so it's a step-by-step process. First, we listed out the requirements, then we prioritize them. Even in the process, if you come across any new thought process, you might again put it here or here. Fine. Again, observation from this, I saw a couple of them. Like in this team, I saw the sticky is going down. Means they think that whatever they wrote earlier was a new feature, but it is a common feature. Right? Second, intense discussion again was happening when we were prioritizing. So somebody think what is important, something know this is important, right? Anything else to share from your team? You had this kind of discussion?
No, we did not. You said no prioritizing right now.
No, prioritizing. So when you said top 10 features, in top 10, if you have 12 features, So you say, okay, these are the top.
Oh, chuck this out and get this. Okay.
So something on the screen. Did you have any kind of what? Yeah. So as opposed to the first round, what additional was there in the second round when you were doing discussion?
Trying to figure out the relevance of what the features
we have. That is right. So you were having those discussions, right?
Yes.
Was happening, right?
Yeah.
Right. So that is the thing that will happen, and it will more refine a product. Now we have done that. Now we have listed the features. We have grouped them together. We have grouped them, you know, as a group. We know how my LMS would look like, and we have prioritized it. Now you have prioritized it. Now the thing comes. Now you know what my product is. Okay, individually, your product owner को पता है कि मेरा product कैसा है. Product owner को ध्यान है क्या product में? नहीं है ना? है? पक्का? See, so the thing is, product owner and team was what I'm trying to say. They were all working as one entity. So now the next step is out of these prioritized thing. Now we have to think what is it. So we come to something called. Now we are going, I'm jumping a little gun here. We are going to a step called release plan. So when we talk of release planning, so right now no development, nothing is there. So you are a product owner as a group, as a team. Now you want to figure out what is it that I want to come, you know, I want my lead management system. How can I release it? So when you in Agile, why you adopt Agile? So that you can have quicker time to market, you can release product quickly. Now there has to be a balance between how you want to release it and whether it make business sense or not. Early and business sense or not. So for example, in one team you might say that I want to release LMS on the mobile device. So we know as a user we are using it on mobile. What is it that will value, that will create value for you if you want to see? Some can say, even if I have only holiday calendar available, it is valued for me. Other might say, until and unless it does not have a capability to apply lean, I don't find value in this. Right? So these are two different things. So you would have to figure out in your product backlog, right? What is that value? That what are the all the features you want to bring out? Right? So isme ek step jo hota hai, first step is you have prioritized it, right? From a prioritizing perspective, you have to now just think about what is it that you want to roll out first. Right? So you might so Abhik, because we said we did not sequence it, right? Now when you sequence it as a application, again development is why I'm bringing development, is that development mindset hampers thought process. So as a user, people want to see what are the things which I want to release and what sequence. So sabse pehle login dikhna chahiye, fir uske baad holiday calendar ho sakta hai, ya uske baad home page ho sakta hai jispe I would have my entire lead balance, or second page could be directly the page landing page of where I can apply lead. So you're getting, so the first, now the step is you sequence it, what is it that you want to come out first, and then think what would be your release timeline. So in your product, whatever 10 feature, 8 features you would have, first aapne sequence kar liya, when you want to release. So some might say I want to release after only 2 features, another might say I want to release after 4 features, right? So every time when you do this discussion, you would see change happening here. Either cheezen aage peeche jayengi ya usme cheezen add hongi, and anytime if new requirement is coming to your mind, feel free to add it. Okay, next step jo thoda sa tedious hota hai, because you have number of stickies. What we can do is, just for the scope of this session, ye main stickies hai, right? Right, these are your, so leave them as it is. We'll assume that they are theek hai, ye hai, but we would sequence only these top rows. Right, so our sequence, so we would have a final sequence, and then uske upar jahan bhi aapko lagta hai your release. So when we say release means releasing to production, you know, we are not talking of UAT and all that term. So right now, release to production. So you put a sticky and write R1, big R1. So if you think after sequencing, after 2, you want to have your first release, you have to upar sticky lagao, uspe ek R1 likhe. So you could have R1, you could have R1, R2, you could have R1, R2, R3, R4. So it is up to the team to decide as a group, how do you want to release your lead management system.
So for the exercise we can assume release 3 releases?
You can assume 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. As a group, you want to figure out ki mere group ki jo LMS aega, when I see that people will find the backlog. Right. So sequence and R.
एक हॉलिडे कैलेंडर भी हमारा
मैंने
भी कंपनी हॉलिडे
का नाम डाल दिया
तो सबसे पहले तो लॉगिन तो होना ही चाहिए और अप्लाई करने का सबसे पहले इसके बाद रिपोर्ट्स वगैरह
बस बस ये लो
अगर हमारे पास हमने बोलेंगे तो फिर हम हॉलीडे कैलेंडर देखेंगे देन हम लीव के लिए भी अप्लाई करेंगे मतलब समझे मेरा
नहीं नहीं अभी सीक्वेंसिंग हमें करनी है व्हेन डू वी रिलीज दिस फीचर रिलीज अभी रिलीज में नहीं करेंगे हमको अपनी हॉलीडेज तो पता होगा अभी मुझे सिर्फ अप्लाई करने का फीचर देना बाकी मैं जल्दी से
मार्केटिंग
वेलकम
लॉगिन अप्लाई और नोटिफिकेशन अप्लाई एंड नोटिफिकेशन
तीन फीचर
We are not doing sprint planning right now. We are doing release planning.
So the third one could be
approval
or rejection.
Approval
or rejection would be
ये ऊपर क्या पहुंच गए
ये स्टेकर द फीचर्स द टॉप वन इन वन एंड देन मोर मार्केट लाइक R1 ओवर स्टिकी सो देयर आर टू मेनी
सो वेयर इज योर R1 हैपनिंग
सो दैट इज दैट्स द R1 हैपनिंग
दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग
या
बट एट द सेम टाइम
आई थिंक स्टार्टेड विद इट सो या मेबी यू कैन
Why you putting this on top of that? You want these things and the release one. So what we were saying was, these are release one. So this is your top line, right? So if this is your release one, take it on the left side. So left side would have the feature and the left side. And what you do, this is second, this is third, right?
This is third. Mark all three as release one.
No, no, no. What you do is here, and a sticky, paste a sticky and write R1.
these three features will be part of the business model, right?
Yeah, yeah, that's what
I'm saying.
On top. You see the team.
They're just doing this,
Okay, we're good. Now again, what are we doing? When we are now thinking of release, did you do a sequencing change? Did you do a change in the sequence?
Yes.
Something that you were in the priority top 10 items, you now started thinking from what is it would value to the end user, to me, when I want to have the release, when I want to see the application, right? Right? So the next, now what we have is, we have a refined product backlog, which is prioritized, okay? So what is a product backlog? By the definition, product backlog is the list of
prioritized features.
Prioritized. You got feature, user story, but it's a prioritized thing. And who do the priority?
Product owner.
So right now, product owner akele nahi karta, because product owner is working at the back with all the business users and all. So you all for the moment were business users. So we have done the priority and now we are priority is set. And this is the release, R1, R2, R3. Abhi tak, development team question mein nahi hai. So what is the reason for these release? Well, release rule defined. The development needs to come in picture. But why we do this R1, R2, R3?
So business can start reaping the benefits
soon. Thought process of when the business would realize benefits. That is the basic reason of identifying R1, R2, R3. If the product owner is technically savvy or technical hands-on, he might understand technical challenge also. In case if he is not, in many cases, which is a realistic scenario. So, but this is what is required from his side to figure out, what value I want to drive out of and when exactly I want to release the product. Okay, so that is where R1, R2, R3 are there. So now, in your case, what is the R1 happening? R1 is happening, R1 mein aap kya kya release kar rahe hai?
Login screen hai, apply for a new leave and email notification.
So a leave application and leave email notification. Aapke team mein kya hai? What is R1?
Login, apply and approve.
Okay, approve is also going. Now?
Same here, login, apply and approve.
Login, apply and approve.
Login, apply and cancellation.
Login, apply and cancellation. Okay. In this way?
Login, apply.
So we see the okay. Now the next step is our release are defined. One more thing for our product owner is heard something around velocity.
Yeah.
Right? Now what additional benefit customer can drive out of it is, now if we know that this is a team from whom I want to get my work done and this is an agile team, right, on the .NET or whatever technology. Now I know the based on past project, what is the velocity of this team. So velocity of this team assume is 20 story points per sprint, and I assume that sprint is of 3 weeks. Okay, so every 3 weeks they have been on an average turning out 30 story points of work. Okay, now I would sit with my DA in case the Scrum Master or in a scenario where a Scrum Master or the technical person is also available, I sit with them and do a high level story point of this. Now, if my entire product story point is say 300 story points,
entire, right? I know I'm getting this done by this team whose velocity is 30 story point. How many sprints I need? How many sprints? I need 10 sprints. 10 sprints are 4 weeks each, or 3 weeks each. 3 weeks each. So I get a idea around how much my this product would take time, which I can relate with my wherever, the value. And so as a product owner, I want to know how much time the development team would take. Right, so that is the reason that we do estimation here in story point. The product owner do that story point, and if it is being developed by a new team, things are little taken differently. But if we develop by the same team, we have a rough idea of how many story points they take, and we'll get idea of how long this thing would take, because everything is planning, right? Okay, but in Agile, the key difference is that whatever it's a plan. It's not a commitment. Because in waterfall, in a typical jab hum koi project plan submit karte hain, what we do? We break them down into tasks. We call a senior person, we say 8-10-12 ghante laga diye, and uske baad we figure out based on our capacity and all that stuff, buffer and everything, this is what is the proposed timeline when I'll release it, and I submit it to the customer. Now this is what it is, a plan. But customer take it as a commitment. That is a key difference. Yes, it happens. Right. So, har jagah yahi hota hai na. So, isme drive karte hain, the mindset of collaboration kind of thing. Okay, now we have done this. Ab hamara next step kya hai? This is a product backlog. So, you as a team, this is your product backlog. This is your product backlog as a team. Right? A product owner kaam hai, ek baar fir se aap uthein. Okay, now our role would come. Now we'll do a small simulation. Product owner, is that the one, product owner? Okay, product owner?
No.
Role change karna kya raha hai?
Nahi nahi.
Okay, now what we'll do is, jo bhi aapne banaya hai na, we have to make a paper mock-up of that. You understand what is a paper mock-up? Paper mock-up is, say I'll give you these sheets, and thoda sa isko way judiciously use karega. Okay, so for example, you have 10 features. I give this to this team. What you would have to do is whatever your application is, remember it is mobile device, right? So you have to make a mock-up of how the screen would look. Right, you click on this, click on yes, what is the next page? When you'll give a, when someone would give a demo, he would say, this is my next page. When I say back, SL. When I say click on this, if I want to go as a product owner, jo aap demo doge, product owner doge, apne bande ko doge, because for we are driving a product owner thing also. So, but we can question now, I want to do some additional feature. I want to do something from this requirement. So the person who is presenting should be able to tell where to click and how we'll go there. So that is what you would be presenting, right?
Call it prototype or live?
Pre-gaming.
Kuch
bhi bol. What we call this is a paper mock-up, right? Prototype, wireframe, because wireframes are actually very detailed and we are not creating wireframe here. But abhi aapne jaise dekha ki jab aap ye bana rahe the, discussion ho raha tha na. Now when you make this also, you'll see that thing. So that is what you have to make, fine. I'll give these sheets and we'll run this in a sprint fashion. Okay, so what we'll do is I'll give you maybe 5 minutes. How much time we have? So this activity might take 1 minute. So we'll take another 5 minutes and we'll do a sprint planning. Now planning na kya karte ho? We take the items, right? Usme actual planning mein hota hai. We take the stories and usko technical tasks mein break down karte hain. Usme technical tasks hai nahi, right? So what you will do is sit together, figure out how the layout of this would look, how the flow would look based on your product backlog. If you have any question, where you will go to your product owner. So jo bhi product owner hai, just be clear of what we want, okay. Fine. And any question, you go to the product owner, spend another 5 minutes to create the flow. Don't start drawing on these, right? Spend 5 minutes to create a flow of this, how it will look. Second thing is, who will do what? So if there are 5 screen or 10 screen in your thing, so pehla kaun banayega, dusra kaun banayega, you can do all that division, right? So this is what we do in sprint planning. Who will coordinate this sprint planning?
Scrum Master.
But the, everybody would work together. Abhi, interest of time, I'm not going into the burn downs and all. Otherwise, we can use this activity to capture how much amount of time. Achha, burn down kaise banta hai? Let's touch that quickly. What does burn down tell?
How much work is left?
In sprints, current sprints. In what is the unit of that?
In hours.
So when we do the sprint, may what it tells is the good part is that if our sprint is say a 4-day sprint, a weekly sprint, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. On the day one, it will tell you on the day zero if my amount of work is say 100 hours. Okay, for the entire week, and our week sprint is a week. So you have to come like this. So this is our fifth day. So you start with 100 on the day zero. On the end of the day, you should have zero left. What burn down show is, after day one, how much amount of work is left? If the amount of work is left here, this means kaam thoda sa kam hua, right? Because it is amount of hours left is, you know, it should be here. So the in a realistic scenario, this line keeps on going like this and whatever. But our target of a team on a day-to-day basis is, so after day one, when you do your daily stand-up, you see if it is up, you discuss among yourself what is the reason for. One of the team member might have, you know, started a task, he figured out that it is not that small, it is big. So some course correction needs to be taken. And similarly, just so burn down on a day-to-day basis tells how a project is going. And we need to look at this. So it tells the amount of hours of work left day on day. Okay, so that is important. So we can do all that as part of this, but abhi hum usko skip karte hai. So our thing is, I'll give you this. Aap log, main bas page aap log ko de raha hun. We start our 5 minutes now. And in fact, let me copy karne. Let me give you these pages, then you can start. Because if the page haath mein lewa, you will not have a feeling of how my mobile kind of thing would look. True. See, it's all about user experience. The good part would happen when you will give a demo. Yes. Yes, please.
For preparing the burn down chart, do we need the team together? For preparing the burn down chart, do we need the team together?
Okay, we'll take up the questions now. You have a question?
My question is, for preparing the burn down chart, do we need the team together or would it be prepared at the time of instead of meeting?
Okay, anybody can answer this question?
What is the question?
We'll start planning this 2 minutes. Let's. Question is, in the sprint planning, in preparing the burn down chart, who will prepare the burn down chart? Would we need a team to prepare, or how will that be done?
It denotes how much work is left. So anybody from the team or Scrum Master can do it. But actually, it doesn't matter.
Actually, this is something burn down. Nobody plots. Burn down is in the tool. So what individual have to do is, on a day-to-day basis, after day one, when you have completed your work, instead of logging, so if you have, say, 16 hours of effort of that task, generally, what do? We have done 8 hours. What do we do? Okay, how much is left? 16 minus 8. Assume, right? But in this, what we say is, instead of 8, we'll see, you tell me, do you need only 4 hours to complete this, or do you need 16 hours to complete this? So you as a developer would tell how much amount of effort I need. You enter that time remaining in the system, which simply get collated and it plots. It is nothing like, it is just, aapka kitna time bacha, aapka kitna bacha, usko plot karoga. So the answer to your question is, that goes directly into the tool, and you have to, every individual has to enter the amount of hours left.
By the end.
Okay, so we have papers with everyone. Okay, so Scrum Master, Product Owner, and the team.
I have a question.
Okay.
I still have a doubt, it is number of hours.
Hours is okay.
Because.
Very good question.
Because during sprint planning, you jot down the task and estimate the hours. It is just an estimate. Even it is not crystal clear that these tasks will accommodate to the actual amount of work. Okay. You may have to add the task later. You may have to fix the estimate later. It is quite possible.
So what do you find?
So, burn-down chart will change like every day.
It
should change how much
See,
work is
the
left.
Point, I got it, what you were saying. What his question is, कि ये जो 100 निकाला है ना, ये 100 भी planning है।
हाँ,
तो है।
200 भी हो सकता है, 50 भी हो सकता है।
पर 250 नहीं होगा। Reason being, we are doing things step by step. We have done the product backlogging. We are clear ये जो है, जो हमने exercise करी, ये exercise क्यों करी? So that we are clear on the requirement. If we are clear on the requirement to a greater extent as opposed to a typical waterfall methodology, we are more our estimates are more near to accurate. This is still an estimate. Right, but there is a high possibility that this might not go from 100 to 200. 110 ho sakta hai. Ho sakta hai to wo yahan pe aayega na. Because 100 kya abhi upar ja raha hai. Agar aap, so one of the thing of this burn down is on a day to day basis to check how, agar hum isi speed se kaam kar rahe hain to hamara humko kitna time lagega. So this means jaise this is a point, this is third day, it is above this, right? It is above this. You plot a direct line from here, it will go somewhere here. So it will show that if I am doing at this speed, instead of 5 days, it will complete in 8 days. So what it will show is that to do a course correction, I would have to increase the number of hours per day. Right, so it gives all that information. Now it is up to your team to take that decision. So this is still a plan, but supposedly it will be more near to accurate. Right, and tabhi to isko agile kehte hai ki agile mein, there's so many things coming out. Agile mein, we say that planning, we can do planning at 3 levels. First planning, we are doing at release level. Second planning, sprint. We are doing at sprint level, jo humne ye nikala. Ab isko bhi hum daily level pe change kar sakte. Kyun? Because that is what we are doing. We are entering amount of hours left. And hours left, who is giving? Not the PM, not the system. You as a member, as a developer who is giving on the task is giving. Right, so you are also changing it. So everything is visible. Now as a team, you take a course correction, what is to be done. Agar ho sakta hai, nahi ho sakta hai, product owner ko bhi pata hai ki nahi ho sakta. Right, so there are no surprises. Agile itna hi karta hai. Iska agar nahi karta. So iska, theek hai. So let's now quickly, what we do is, I'll time it for another 5 minutes. I'll time it for 5 minutes. We would have to do our planning. So planning mein, you would... For this exercise, again, you are doing a paper mock-up for your requirements.
Release-wise.
We are not talking about release. Release chapter is closed now. Yeah. So, because we are simply drawing, no? So, we would be able to draw the thing. What is important is how the layout should look like, who will do what kind of drawing. So, that is what you have to do in a team. Okay? So, all that. Abhi drawing start nahi karenge. The drawing will start when the sprint is starting. We are doing the sprint planning. So first thing is, you identify how the layout would look. You might have 2 people working on the drawing. You might have all 5 people working on the drawing. The testers need to ensure whatever they are doing should be matching the requirements that product owner has given. And product owner, when these people are doing, you just keep quiet for a moment. Okay? And just see whatever they are doing. And you don't have to interrupt them because we are just trying to inculcate or bring that that thing. So, pehle let's start 5 minutes and do this planning.
Are you talking about the sprint 0?
Sprint 0 looks like it. We are not talking about sprint 0. So, sprint planning karte, right? Sprint planning is done on the first day of the sprint, right? Of the start, maybe another 2 hours, 3 hours that you spend. It might go longer or shorter depending on how much you are prepared, how much clarity the product owner has on the requirement, how much your Scrum Master or business analyst understand these things. Okay, so let's do this sprint planning for our product. So end thing I want.
I'm going to go to the manager.
कैंसिलेशन की बात
कर रहा है सब मसल कौन है सी हॉलीडे चैलेंजर